10 stars that can't stand The Rock Johnson. Wrestler turned movie star Dwayne The Rock Johnson has had a legendary career graph. From WWF ring to Hollywood, he has made friends and enemies alike. It doesn't matter which part of the world you belong to, it is difficult to not be charmed by this Hollywood macho man. But similar polls repel and stars hate stars. There are some stars who cannot stand The Rock, and for good reasons. Let's look at 10 such stars. Coming in at number 10, we have John Cena. Most feuds of Rock can be traced to wrestling, and this one is no exception. Before John Cena made a career transition from wrestling to acting and music, he was critical of The Rock doing the same. In an interview with The Sun in 2008, he said about Rock, he, at one point, loved wrestling and wanted to do this all of his life. He went on with the rant, "Explain to me why he can't come back for a 15th anniversary show or why he can't make an appearance at WrestleMania. Simply put, it's because he wants to be an actor," he added. "Just don't me around and tell me that you love this when you are just doing this to do something else. That's the only thing that gets me really pissed off." Cena had to later eat his words when he himself threw his hat in the acting ring. "This is a very tough balancing act, and I called Johnson out because of ignorance," Cena admitted while apologizing and saying he was wrong. "I called him out as someone who had tunnel vision in WWE and didn't understand the process that when you make a movie, you are not allowed to do anything else. Both enjoy a good relationship now, but past is never forgotten." Coming at number 9, we have Randy Orton. The Rock made an epic switch from wrestling to acting. In doing so, he opened the doors for many wrestlers to look up to his second innings of glory. But the Scorpion King has also antagonized many fellow wrestlers along the way. Randy Orton is one. He took pot shots at The Rock when asked about an upcoming WrestleMania match between Dwayne Johnson and John Cena during a 2011 ESPN interview. "I think Cena will own The Rock," Orton said. "I think Cena is wittier and can go off the cuff. Cena writes his own stuff, while The Rock has stuff written for him. It just all comes down to who you are in the ring and what kind of performer you are in the ring, and I think Cena is 10 times the performer in the ring that The Rock is." Orton later said that he got in trouble for putting that out there. "I heard WWE CEO Vince McMahon was mad," he said, "and John Laurinaitis, the vice president of talent relations, pulled me aside and had a little talk with me and told me that Vince was upset and I shouldn't have said this going into WrestleMania." It was revealed that Rock called the office and said, "Yeah, you know, Randy Orton did an interview and he buried me," according to Orton. He later confronted Johnson and asked, "Is that what we do here? Ouch." Coming at number 8, we have Tyrese Gibson. Johnson is an actor and producer. In that capacity, he can pull a lot of strings that he keeps doing with changing priorities. This doesn't always go down well with close associates. His Fast and Furious franchise co-star Tyrese Gibson was dismayed when Johnson delayed Fast and Furious 9 for his solo spin-off Hobbs and Shaw. Feeling let down, Gibson slammed Johnson on Instagram for making the Fast and Furious franchise about you and questioned whether it would be another hashtag Baywatch, a Johnson-led flick that flopped. He also mocked the movie's average first week box office collection. "He tried," Gibson wrote in part in a since-deleted Instagram via MovieWeb. "Breaking up the family clearly doesn't have the value that one would assume it does. Hobbs and Shaw has lowest Fast and Furious box office opening since Tokyo Drift." But to Gibson's disappointment, the saw a global surge after a slow start. And killer blow came from Johnson's tweet. "Remember, the best way to shut the mouth of a clown is to flex with success and a smile." Coming at number 7, we have Vin Diesel. The two big bald men somehow look like natural rivals, and they have expectedly collided more than once. During the making of The Fate of the Furious, The Rock posted, "My female co-stars are always amazing and I love them. My male co-stars, however, are a different story. Some conduct themselves as stand-up men and true professionals, while others don't. The ones that don't are too chicken to do anything about it anyway, candy ass." Vin Diesel knew exactly whom The Rock was referring to and confronted the WWF giant, which led to a verbal spat between the two. The Rock was concerned and had to make up with another post. "Family is gonna have differences of opinion and fundamental core beliefs. To me, conflict can be a good thing when it's followed by great resolution. I was raised on healthy conflict and welcome it. And like my family, we get better from it." Rock triggered another insta-war with Diesel during Fast and Furious 8, and the love-hate relationship goes on. Coming in at number 6, we have Shawn Michaels. Rock's rivalry with rival wrestling legend Shawn Michaels goes back to the 80s when the former was trying to make a place in WWE. The Heartbreak Kid then worked surreptitiously to keep Johnson down and even insulted his promoter grandmother. After Rock reached the top of the WWE world, he took his sweet revenge by never even considering Michael for a fight. Things boiled down between the two during Johnson's match with Triple H when Shawn kicked him on the face. According to Johnson's dad, Rocky, Shawn threw the karate kick, and I guess he kicked him a little bit too hard, Rocky told the Hannibal TV. So Dwayne came back into the dressing room and told him, "Hey man, you hit me too hard, calm down." But then Michaels got smart with him. He said, "If you can't take it, you shouldn't be in this business." And then, next thing you know, he's on the floor and Dwayne's on top of him. Coming at number 5, we have Anthony Norris. Norris, aka Ahmed Johnson, doesn't exactly hate The Rock, but the two have gotten into offstage brawls. Ahmed revealed the history of bad blood between the two on a couple of occasions. First, during the Perfect Plex radio interview in 2013, he said, "The Rock is the best in history on the mic." He began, "You will never find another guy like that on the mic." But then Ahmed Johnson claimed that he and The Rock once got into a backstage row. He made the statement that his mother had an affair with a white guy and got pregnant with him, so he was denying his black heritage all the way around. Ahmed Johnson added that he confronted The Rock over the matter, saying, "That led to a fight between me and him in the locker room, a fist fight." Then in 2016, he explained his locker room confrontation with The Rock. "I didn't like the fact that he was getting a little too cocky for me and we had a match coming up. Matter of fact, that same night, we was going to the match and I was willing to do his high spots, but he wasn't willing to do all mine. We got into a little confrontation back there." Looks like they have their claws hidden, but still pointed at each other. Coming at number 4, we have Triple H. You can always smell a feud, doesn't matter how tightly it's guarded. Some bad vibes between wrestler-turned-businessman Paul Levesque, aka Triple H, and Rock were revealed by the wrestling industry legends Bruce Pritchard and Ric Flair. While chatting about the two wrestlers on the Woohoo Nation podcast in 2018, Pritchard claimed The Rock and Triple H didn't really care for each other. At this point, Flair interjected with a laugh, "I don't think they do right now." In response, Pritchard said, "I don't know now. I'll tell ya, at the time, there was a professional jealousy. I mean, it was brutal. The audience, man, they felt it because it was real. There was animosity there. There was professional jealousy there. And these two guys didn't like each other." Though Triple H denied the whole thing by saying, "It's always competitive with Rock and I from the very start of our careers," he said during a Facebook Live session the previous year via Wrestling News, adding, "He and I, over the years, we've had this interesting rivalry at a time in our lives when we were really trying to establish ourselves and make something." WWE fans do not buy this as they can feel the veiled hostility between the two champions. Coming at number 3, we have Kevin Nash. The retired wrestler and actor Kevin Nash once admitted about his strained relationship with The Rock, dating back to their wrestling days. He said, "I'm sure I rubbed him the wrong way because I'm an abrasive South Detroit f***ing sucker," he said in an interview with Title Match Wrestling in 2012. "He already f***ed all over his territory and I went there and said, dude, I'll knock you the f*** out." Nash went on to claim that Johnson tried to manage their matches too much, reportedly asking him, "What one thing do you want right there?" The confession acquires a lot of meaning when you think of The Rock Johnson calling Nash Big Daddy B*** during a promo. This blitz was off script and Nash was taken aback, so were the viewers. But as we said, see it with reference to Nash's confession about the past. Things have been boiling up between the two. Coming at number 2, we have CM Punk. In a battle of credits, CM Punk expressed his resentment when Rock took all the credit for the mighty success of WrestleMania 27 in 2011. According to Bleacher Report, the success of this show hinged on one man and one man alone, The Rock. Being the co-star of the event, Punk felt that The Rock's impact was mightily overblown. "I have no personal problems against Dwayne," he said on Mark Madden's radio show via the Bleacher Report. "It's very frustrating being here and watch a guy come in and get credit for a WrestleMania buy rate when he didn't do anything on the show. He certainly didn't do anything entertaining." As always, Rock let his actions speak louder by defeating Punk in 2013 WWE Championship. Coming at number 1, we have Kevin Hart. We end the Scary Man's Enemy list on a lighter note with comedian Kevin Hart. Ever since the pair teamed up for their comedy action film Central Intelligence, The Rock has made it his mission to toy with Kevin Hart whenever they hang out. And he's been having a lot of fun playing pranks on Kevin. During the shoot of the new Jumanji film, Rock exploited Kevin's fear of bugs by throwing a dummy spider by his side. The entire crew, including Rock, broke in bursts of uncontrollable laughter when Kevin ran for his life. Rock even put an Instagram pic of him holding a baby Kevin Hart in his arms. But Hart is a sport for pranks, even if his puny size in front of Rock is ridiculed. He has been involved in a long mutual trolling match with The Rock on social media, and the people are enjoying the shenanigans. That is all for now. Thank you for watching this show. Please make sure to like, share, subscribe, and hit that notification bell for the latest updates.